Since the release of the Ally X, the OG Ally right here with the Z1 Extreme might have some problems, especially if you've upgraded to Armoury Crate 1.5, with some people reporting crashes, some people reporting inputs not registering, or just different kind of errors in the handheld that we never experienced before. Well, let's fix it real quick. I'm Captain Awesome, this is Geekception. I really appreciate it if you hit a like, subscribe, and let's get into it. Okay, essentially the fix we're going to be using today is just resetting Armoury Crate. So let's do that. Let's start by closing Armoury Crate if you have it open. And you can do that by tapping X on the top right and then tap OK to close Armoury Crate SE. Next, tap on your Windows Start icon. Find Armoury Crate SE in your list of apps and press and hold it. In the context menu that pops up, you will see App Settings. Tap on that. This will bring you into the app settings for Armoury Crate SE. Scroll down under the reset section and tap on reset. It'll tell you that this will permanently delete all of your app data. Tap reset. It'll take a short while, but it will notify you after the reset is done. Next, I want you to restart your Ally. On booting up, log into your Ally. Tap on the Armoury Crate button if it's not automatically enabled to start with Windows, and it will launch Armoury Crate. And one thing you'll notice here is that it is as if you are starting afresh. And again, this is because we actually reset Armoury Crate. Scroll down in the privacy policy and tap I accept. Next, it will give you a set of screens showing you some of the features of the updated Armoury Crate 1.5. Tap next through all of them until it finally brings you into the Armoury Crate interface. And we are done. This should fix all the errors that the new Armoury Crate 1.5 update has brought to the Z1 Extreme of the 2023 ROG Ally. As for the reasons for the crashes and errors that may be occurring, I think some of the theories are that the new Armoury Crate 1.5 update is clashing with the previous updates and Armoury Crate files on the Ally right here. And what we just did now, which is just resetting it back to, I guess, factory setting, is just what gives it a fresh new start and hopefully clears some of the issues that might be happening on the Ally, or specifically your Ally. Let me know in the comments down there below if this helped you at all. And for me, what I noticed specifically is that in some games that I was playing, I noticed that, you know, the input was not very responsive and it just felt a bit wonky for me. So it's definitely not as bad for me as some of the other cases I've seen on the ROG Ally subreddit, for example. So hopefully that fixes everything. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you like all I'm doing here. I make all sorts of tech videos, especially about the Ally here. I'll be getting the Ally X very soon as well. So if you want to see some of the content there, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And I will also leave some of the past tips videos I have made for the Ally right here in case you want to go one step further to customize your own Ally. And that's it for this video. Don't forget to text me when you get home so I know you got home safe. And until the next time, I've been your Captain of Awesome. This is Geekception, and I'll catch you in the next one. Don't forget to stay awesome. Bye.